All right, guys, let's talk about Kendrick Lamar's DNA, very popular DNA song. I want to see if we can get through the lyrics and do a breakdown and see what he's talking about. So I'm going to read the lyrics and let's just kind of like break down what the heck is going on. Before I even start, I think that generally, like, this song is about not just bragging about yourself, but just admitting to like your own owning up to who you are. Believing in yourself for the, and owning up to the good and bad that you have inside you. And he's pitting that against, either other people who kind of like don't know who they are, who are, don't stand for nothing, betray, aren't loyal. And he's putting his kind of like DNA and his, personality versus that other person. And that other person could be, I think, it could either be someone within the culture who is a traitor, or someone who is, it could be the establishment, it could be the white man, it could be whatever. I don't think that's super clear, but tell me in the comments below what you think. But so I think, like I said, it's just going, his DNA versus the other person. So he starts off with, I got loyalty, got royalty inside my DNA. Right, so he's talking about loyalty, royalty inside DNA, just like personality. Cocaine quarter piece got war and peace inside my DNA. So he's talking about I got war and I got peace. So I got the good and I got the bad. I got power, poison, pain, and joy inside my DNA. He's just taking all the emotions, putting them together. That's what's inside me, everything all together. I got hustle though. So beside all that, I got hustle though, ambition, flow inside my DNA. So he's taking these rhymes and putting them together and just taking these words that are like, first they go against each other and then they kind of flow together. So it's hustle, ambition, and flow. I was born like this, since one like this immaculate conception. So this is how he was born. I think he means all by himself from the beginning, and comparing himself obviously to the immaculate conception, which is, the whole religious story of Mary and Jesus and Jesus being born, right? Everybody knows Immaculate Conception. Jesus being born without like a father or without, what was it? I don't know. Just without any sex. And he says, I transform like this, perform like this was Yeshua's new weapon. I think so. He's saying, this is how I, just, I. All the stuff that I'm saying just flows through me, whether it's good or bad. I transform from this to that. And this is how I perform. This is how I do everything. This is how I show who I am in front of others. It was Yeshua's new weapon. I don't complain. I don't contemplate. I meditate. Then off your fucking head. So I don't sit around and think and kind of like, I'm gonna contemplate, strategize. I don't think, I think saying like, instead of that, I'm just calm. I meditate. And I just, blow your brains out, right? Hopefully, theoretically speaking. And he says, this that put the kids to bed, this that I got realness. I just kill shit because it's not my DNA. So there's, whatever. I don't think those are that, like, it's super important lines, but this is what put kids to bed. I think it can mean, like, two ways with that. Put kids to bed, like this song puts like kids to bed, like to sleep. People like the songs and they listen to it and they listen to it while they sleep. Also, it can mean put kids to bed, like put other, people out, like just shutting them down and killing them, with his flow. And then he just goes into this. I got realness. I just kill shit 'cause it's not my DNA. I got millions. I got riches building in my DNA, right? So the whole braggioso thing of hip hop and just talking about, being rich and all that stuff. I got dark. I got evil that rot inside my DNA. So now he starts talking about, the evil. I got off. I got troublesome heart inside my DNA. So then you see the song, start from this whole, I got war, I got peace, I got all this stuff, and then, I'm rich and da da da. And I'm like, and then he just starts, I feel like now he starts talking about the evil side. I got dark, I got evil, I got troublesome. So even despite all this, I still got, he's admitting to, to the bad and to the confusion, that anyone could have inside their DNA or inside their heart, inside their, personality. But then he starts off, then he goes back. I just win again, then win again, like Wimbledon. I serve, Wimbledon being the championship in tennis. I serve, you know, like a serve in tennis. I serve people. I serve other rappers. Yeah, that's him again. The sound, that engine is like a bird. You see fireworks and Corvette, tire skirt, the boulevard. So like other people talking about him and who he is and what he's doing. And he got that engine, you know, that people hear. It sounds like fireworks, that Corvette and, you know, skirt on the boulevards. People can hear him. I know how you work. I know just who you are. See, now he's flipping on the other person. Now talking to the other thing where I said he's pitting what he is versus, you know, whatever you guys want to say he's talking about. I'm going to tell him he comes up what you think he's talking about. I just think it could just be, I think he's just talking about like the other person, people who aren't real and the people who claim and aren't and are fakes. That could be the establishment. That could be anybody. So he's saying, I know you. I'm telling you what I am. I'm good. I'm bad. I'm evil. I got war and peace. I got confusion, but I win. He's going like all this stuff inside, but you, I know who you are. I know just who you are. See, you's a bitch. Your hormones probably switch inside your DNA. Problem is all that sucker shit inside your DNA. So your problem is, you know, I know what you're about. I know what you're doing. You're scheming. You don't admit who you are. You know, your hormones probably switch. You got that sucker shit. That's your problem. You're not real. You're not real. You're fake. Daddy probably snitched, right? That's like the worst thing is like if you consider in the streets, like, or in just the culture that you just, you know, someone snitched. So your dad, so you got that heritage inside your DNA. That's what you about. That's the heritage you got, that fakeness, that snitch shit. So then he goes on, backbone don't exist. Born outside a jellyfish, I gauge. So you don't have a backbone. And it's kind of interesting because like jellyfish, right, don't have spine. So if you're spineless, you don't have nothing. So you're born outside that jellyfish. I gauge. And then he goes, see my pedigree. Most definitely don't tolerate the front. So now I know, this is why I think he was talking about someone fake, right? Because he's saying, I don't tolerate the front, the fakeness that the other people are putting up. Not saying who they are. Shit I've been through probably offend you. This is Paula's oldest son talking about his mother. So what I've been through, it probably is going to offend you. You're going to get hurt about the stuff I talk about, the stuff I've been through, my past. You're going to just, you know, you can't take it. I know murder, conviction, burners, boosters, burglars, ballers, dead, redemption, scholars, fathers, dead with kids, and I wish I was fed forgiveness. So, yeah, soldier's DNA. So he's just talking about, now he's talking about like the past and the roots of like just the violence that he was probably born and bred in, even though he still made it in his eyes. But the stuff that you're going to hear me want to say to the other person, stuff that you're going to hear me talk about, it's going to hurt you. But this is what I am. Burners, guns, boosters, burglars, you know, redemption, fathers dead with kids. And he said, I wish I was fed forgiveness. I wish, you know, we had some kind of solace or some kind of like tranquility, but we didn't have that. So I'm a soldier. So inside my DNA is a soldier's DNA. That's just what it is. Born inside the beast. My expertise checked out in second grade, right? Just a little hip hop. Just like, you know, when I was young, you know, even though, I mean, I don't know if you checked out in second grade, but, you know, Kendrick Lamar probably did. When I was 9, on sale, motel, we didn't have nowhere to stay. So that sounds like it's a little bit, he's bringing up something in the past where when he was 9, you know, I don't, maybe he had to stay in a motel, he didn't have nowhere to go. But at 29, I've done so well, hit cartwheel in my state, and I'm going to shine like I'm supposed to. So after all that, I'm 29, and I'm doing good for myself. And then again, he goes back to that opposing, the two opposing things, antisocial, extrovert. How are you antisocial? But then you're extrovert, you go out and talk to people. But you people have both sides. And excellent mean the extra work. So he's excellent, but it's because of the extra work he puts in. That just, that's kind of cool because, like, although he's talking about his DNA and how he's just born and bred, there's also this, you know, the idea that, you know, he's also puts in the extra work. And that's what makes him who he is. And then he goes on, absentness, what the fuck you heard? and pessimists never struck my nerve, so he's never been, out of the picture. And people who are negative, they never affected him. And Nazareth gonna plead his case, the reason my power is here on earth. Salute the truth when the prophets say. So just like, Nazareth, I think being Jesus, I don't know, he's bringing that religion side. I think just because it's a story that, like, someone who, like, got killed on a cross, according to the story, that he's gonna plead my case, talk about who I am, talk about what I've been through, and the power and the reason my power is here on earth because of that. He's gonna tell that story. Then he just goes on. I got loyalty, got royalty inside my DNA. Back to the bridge. I got, and then there's like a background clip of Geraldo, a news reporter who was talking about, like, who's anti-rap. He says, this is why I say that hip hop has done more damage to young African Americans than racism in recent years. Some clip, some Fox News clip that, plays in the background. And he goes on, I got loyalty, got loyalty, got royalty inside my DNA. I live a better life. I'm rolling several dice. Fuck your life. I got loyalty, got royalty inside my DNA. I live a better life. Fuck your life. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. This is my heritage. All I'm inheriting, money and power, the mecca of marriages. So again, he's talking about that DNA has all this bad and good inside. So this is my, this is my heritage, my history, and this is all I'm inheriting. It's everything I got to give, and this is everything that I'm gonna give to others. Then he goes on to verse 2. Tell me something, you motherfuckers can't tell me nothing. I'd rather die than to listen to you. Very obvious. My DNA not for imitation. Your DNA, an abomination. This is how it is when you're in the matrix, dodging bullets, reaping what you sow, and stacking up the footage, living on the go. So just again, just like talking about, that was very clear. I don't think it needs any explanation. My DNA is not for imitation. Your DNA is fake. And everybody knows the Matrix, that movie with Neo, where he goes into the Matrix and he has to choose between living the life that just was given to him or taking the other pill that will show him what exactly is happening in life and how he could choose his own destiny. And in the movie, Neo does things like dodge bullets. Neo's the main character, and I think he means by reaping what you sow, you get what you give. And then he goes and sleeping in a villa, sipping from a Grammy, and walking in the building, diamond in the ceiling, marble on the floors, beach outside the window, peeking out the window. So just all, fancy stuff. Now he's just bragging a little bit here about all the stuff he got, all the stuff he made, got out of his success. Peeking out the window, maybe looking at, and then he goes peeking out the window, baby in the pool, Godfather goals, only Lord knows. I've been going hammer, dodging paparazzi, freaking through the cameras. I think all this stuff's pretty clear. It's not that deep. I think it's just now just showing a little bit of bragging, a little bit of rhyming here. Eat at Four Daughters, Brock wearing sandals, yoga on a Monday. It's funny to have Kendrick Lamar talk about yoga and stretch into Nirvana. So now he goes on to saying, watching all the snakes, curving all the fakes. So I just bragging about his life, right? I don't find this part like super interesting, but I think it just like it's like kind of like the first verse went to the history and the personal DNA that he had, and then like the second verse is kind of like going into, just like his modern life, just however it is now. Yoga, stretching to Nirvana, watching all the snakes, curving all the fakes, and now he goes on to say, I'm still paying attention for you people. Phone never on. I don't conversate. I don't compromise. I just penetrate. I just keep doing my thing. Sex, money, murder. These are the breaks. So I don't, mess around on the phone, just BSing. I don't compromise. I don't like compromise my values or whatever it is I gotta do. I just do it, and then I just keep going. I just penetrate. These are the times. Level number 9. Looking up in the sky. 10 is on the way. Some people say like. Level number 9, I'm not fully clear if anybody knows what that is. Put it in the comments. Looking up in the sky, 10 is on the way. Some people say that that's referring to some kind of old, god in Egypt or something like that. But that's not fully clear if you want to put that in there, if anyone knows. Sentence on the way, killings on the way, motherfucker, I got winners on the way. So I think he's just saying, like, all the stuff that's coming, that's going to be coming to the other person, I think. Killings and sentence, like, maybe like criminal sentences, and for him, he got winners on the way. So he has good, the other person has bad because he's not owning up to his DNA. You ain't shit without a body on your belt, right? You ain't shit without a ticket on your plate. You ain't sick enough to pull it on yourself. You ain't rich enough to hit the lot and skate. Tell me when destruction gonna be my face. Now he goes on. So I think like those few bars, just like talking about the other person he's talking about, or the other, whatever it is, he's just saying like you ain't shit without, I think he was talking about cops, like without a body on your belt, without like using the gun on your belt to kill someone. That you ain't shit without that bullshit you're doing, not the fakeness, that kind of thing. I think he's throwing that in my opinion. You could tell me in the comments what you think. You ain't shit without a ticket on your plate. I think he means here, and that's kind of interesting. I feel like that's like a ticket, kind of maybe talking about the cops, but how to give tickets. But you ain't shit without a ticket on your plate, like without like getting like a meal ticket, without getting a free pass also. Like you ain't shit unless you got that free pass, but you didn't build this like me. Like what's in my DNA? I went from nothing to building, something, So that's what he's talking about. You ain't sick enough to pull it on yourself. In other words, you ain't sick enough to kill yourself for what you're doing. And at the same for the bad for the stupid shit you're doing, and at the same time you ain't rich enough to hit the lot and skate. So out of all that shit you're doing, you're still not rich enough like me to enjoy the life. So tell me when destruction gonna be my fate, gonna be your fate, gonna be our fate. Peace to the world, let it rotate. Sex, money, murder, our DNA. So I think that's like, I love the way that ends. I love the way that's like that. I love the way that ends. Gonna be your. So tell me when destruction gonna be my fate, gonna be your fate, gonna be our fate. Peace to the world, let it rotate. Sex, money, murder, our DNA. Just going back to saying, like, all that shit I talked about is our DNA. Tell me when it's all gonna end for you, for me, for everybody. But the world just gonna keep going around. So, an awesome song. It's doing really good. Kendrick Lamar, DNA. Tell me what song you wanna talk about next, or you wanna break down. And tell me in the comments below some of the bars, what you thought it meant. Like, who is Kendrick Lamar really talking about in this song, DNA? I'll see you guys in the next video.